progress.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and a very good morning. Welcome to the Business Forum on Processed Food. We are honored that you are able to take part in today's forum. And my name is Miratu Alam, and I'm honored to be your moderator and MC for this morning. Today's forum aims to understand better the regulations as well as product entry permit requirement in exporting processed food. Today also aims to give business people the opportunity to directly inquire partnering country regulators, especially countries where Indonesia experiences obstacle in exporting goods such as Turkey. Today we have a speaker from Indonesia and four representatives from Turkey. The representative from the Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry of the Republic of Turkey will join us online via Zoom. We'll have two presenting and two more will be available should you wish to ask more questions beyond the scope of their presentations. Everyone will be able to participate in the question and answer session at the end of the presentations. There will be translator from Turkish to Indonesia and vice versa should you need translating. So please write down your questions and save them for when the presentations finish. For our online participants, if you wish to ask a question, you are welcome to press the raise hand button. And when I call your name, you may unmute your mic and ask your question. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I'd like to introduce our very first speaker, who is a graduate of the prestigious Bandung Institute of Technology, as well as University of Indonesia. She is the Director of Processed Food Distribution Control from Indonesia FDA. Please welcome Dr. Ratna Irawati APT MKes. Dr. Ratna, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Mrs. MC. Distinguished colleagues from Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry, Republic of Turkey, Dr. Neslihan Alper, Dr. Mehmet Diri, Dr. Osman Shakir, and Dr. Sibel Bas. Distinguished colleagues from ministries and institutions in Indonesia, distinguished Indonesian processed food business actors, a very good morning to all of you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, we would like to welcome our colleagues from Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry, Republic of Turkey, in Pavilion Indonesia at Dubai World Expo. It is a pleasure to have you here with us. We also would like to convey our appreciations for your presence here in the context of future collaborations and discussions. In this occasion, I will present briefly about innovation in food safety control in Indonesia, what we do to strengthen food safety control in Indonesia. As we know, the food chain consists of production, processing, distribution, storage, until consumption in Indonesia. Slide. Next slide. From production until that food is ready for consumption, involve many stakeholders so that to realize safe and good quality food, good coordination is needed to meet people's expectations. Next slide, please. The Indonesian government applies system controls for food produced and distributed in Indonesia with three-tier supervision, namely by the government, the producer, and the public as consumer. This is aimed at effectiveness and reducing the risk that might occur. Next slide. Next slide, please. Processed food control in full spectrum can be described as follows with the principles of control, controlling aspects of food safety, quality, and nutrition throughout the product life cycle is an integral part of the chain that cannot be separated. The data obtained from the results of the evaluation of product registration or pre-market evaluation, especially those that indicate risk with efforts to accelerate licensing, become input for post-market control and vice versa. The cycle starts from the prevention, standardization, licensing, certification, coaching, and post-market control evaluation. It is inspection of production facilities, inspection of distribution facilities, export-import food control, and also we do the food sampling and laboratory testing. This is about contamination and product characteristic, and also we monitor a label. Along with advance in information and communication technology, the Indonesian FDA also made innovations and breakthrough by digitalizing the quality control and food. Code of practice is a control standard for high-risk foods because of the height and wide exposure and the high level of product risk. Based on risk-based inspection, it requires a critical point in conducting control. This principle controlling is carried out but during non-pandemic period as well as during pandemic times like today. So, in Food Law number 18/2012 on Food Article 91, it is stated that food business is required to have registration approval. Processed food registration is conducted electronically. The site address is ereg.pom.go.id. Registration approval issued by the head of agency based on the food safety, quality, and nutrition evaluation. There are several innovations that have been carried out to accelerate the food registration process, such as digitalization of the registration, deregulation of the requirements, simplification of the process, providing so many access for information and complaints so public can get in touch easily. For instance, electronic-based media of processed food registration information, online consultation and live chat, call center, social media, communication publication through digital marketing, and online seminar. And also, service assistance for registration process. In Indonesia, we have a GMP certification for food establishment. GMP certificate is a legal document that declares that the producer of processed foods has been complied and has implemented the standard of GMP in food processing. Every producer that produces low and medium risk food, including those who perform the processing, preservation, and repacking of food for distribution in Indonesia, is obliged to have a GMP certificate. The GMP certificate validity period is 5 years, and 6 months prior to its expired dates, producers are expected to register for renewal of their GMP certificate. As shown on the screen, please, yeah, these are steps of GMP certification. And first step is account registration. GMP certificate process is integrated with Ministry of Investment using the online single submission. We call OSS. The implementation of risk-based business licensing through the online single submission system, the implementation of law number 11 of 2020 concerning job creation. So, in our routine activity, we have 34 district offices and 40 local offices all over Indonesia to conduct safety control by doing inspection to food business operator, facility along the food chains, and furthermore, to strengthen the control in food production sector. We also develop the RMP. In Indonesia, the law relating to food distribution control in East Indonesian FDA, Regulation Number 21, Year 2020-21, about implementation of a safety and quality assurance system for processed food in distribution facilities. We call the SMKPO. SMKPO is a system compiled and developed to ensure the safety and quality of processed food in distribution facilities. SMKPO is a system compiled and developed to ensure the safety and quality of processed food through risk-based self-control in distribution chain. So after being certified by SMKPO, business actors are required to conduct an internal audit to be reported to the head of Indonesian FDA at least every 6 months via a certification.pom.go.id. And the SMKPO inspector will conduct an internal audit evaluation and may conduct a surveillance audit to ensure the implementation of the SMKPO. According to the government regulation number 18-6 year 2019 on food safety, it is stated that food entering Indonesian market shall obtain import approvals when food is suspected may endanger human health. Laboratory testing shall be conducted, and when it does not comply with the regulation, the import approval is not issued, and the food shall be destroyed or re-imported. For export and import, we have an online system named eBPOM, and it can be accessed through the website. The document valid for each shipment, it is real-time evaluation, and recommendation is issued within 24 hours, and it also paperless. So we did some innovations in export and import system, such as simplification of export license procedure, online export license, application of digital signature, service level agreement acceleration by digital signature, time-based export license, exported priority program, and website development about export information. And for import, we do the simplification of import license procedure, importer priority program, and service level agreement acceleration about 6 hours. So for export license, the timeline of document evaluation is only 1 day. The system for food is implemented by Indonesian FDA head office and regional offices. For your information, there are two types of export license. There are a health certificate and also the certificate of resale. To increase our service, we have implemented digital signature for export license. First implementation in 2018 with verification code, signature and printed stamp, and barcode. And in collaboration with National Cyber and Crypto Agency, Republic of Indonesia. Authenticity verification by scanning QR code, and this is impact for shortened service time and reduce direct service. Other convenience that we gave to the enterprises is time-based export license, and also this license is valid for 6 months, so this license can be used repeatedly according to export requirement within 6 months. We give this license to the enterprises who have good track record and should have approval from export destination country. To support business actors, we also have a platform, namely Export Consultation Desk. Export Consultation Desk is an innovation of public service of Indonesian FDA, which is intended to assess drug and food business actors that intend to export. There are some information in ECD, such as export requirements and regulation of drug and food products in export destination countries. And this platform also have been linked to WTO and other ASEAN notification platforms. As a closing of my presentation this time, I hope the good cooperation between Turkey and Indonesia related to food control, especially between the Indonesian FDA and Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry, Republic of Turkey, especially related to food control, such as exchange data and information, such as export and import requirements, market conditions and opportunity, and mutual recognition of digitally signed health certificate, certificate of free sale documents issued by the Indonesian FDA. Signing comprehensive economic partnership agreement between Turkey and Indonesia in order to support trade and investment growth between two countries increase. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Ratna. Our next guest is the head of Department of Border Inspection for Plants and Plants Products. She graduated first place from Hacı Tepe University Food Engineering Department in 1990. In the same year, she received the İhsan Dogramacı High Success Award. She worked as a research assistant in the same department and completed her doctorate program in 2001. Please welcome Dr. Neslihan Alper.
Thank you very much.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm Neslihan Alper, and I'm working as the head of Department of Border Control Inspection for Plant and Plant Products under General Directorate of Food and Control in Turkey. I will make a presentation for import and export requirements for processed plant origin foods in Turkey. Yes, we begin the presentation, please. Yes, this is our general directorate. Okay. Now is the full screen. Yes, next please. This is Directorate General of Food and Control in Turkey. All food inspections and regulations is making under this directorate. Next, please. Our mission is to achieve the accessibility of safe food and quality agricultural products, which are needs of our country and world markets. The another mission is to ensure the sustainable use of agricultural and ecological resources. And the next, to determine and implement policies in order to raise the standard of living in rural areas. Also, our vision is for food and agriculture area to ensure the highest level of producer and consumer satisfaction and to make Turkey a leader in region and global actor in the world. Next, please. This is organization scheme. Director General, in the Director General, there is 11 departments for veterinary services, phytosanitary, food and feed issues. Some of them is plant protection products department, plant health quarantine department, border inspection for plant and plant products is my department, food establishment and codex department, food and laboratories, food control and laboratories, feed, animal health and quarantine, veterinary health products, and public health, border inspection for animal and ant products, and the last one is risk assessment department. Next, please. Also, the director generate work with 81 provincial directories, 20 agricultural quarantine directories, 8 research institutes, 1 institute director for food and mouth disease, 23 veterinary border inspection posts, and 41 public control laboratories, which is accredited to ISO 21. Yes, next, please. Moreover, provision of food safety and protection of public health, collaborative studies are carried out with international organizations such as European Food Safety Authority, World Organization for Animal Health, Food and Agriculture Organization of United Nations, World Health Organization, European Medicine Agency, European Directorate for Quality of Medicines and Healthcare, European and Mediterranean Plant Protect Organization, and International Plant Protect Convention. Last one, the World Trade Organization. Next, please. Our directorate defines its food safety policy as food safety from field to table. Next. Our food law named Veterinary Services, Plant Health, Food and Feed Law, number 5996, was adopted in Turkish Grand National Assembly on June 11, 2010. This law is also harmonized with regulation EC regulation number of 178, laying down the general principles and requirements of food law and adopted by the European Parliament Council 2002. Yes. The reflection of this law is enables sole authority, single law, integrated approach, business responsibility, risk assessment, traceability, and transparency. In this framework, what about the legislation on processed food import and its requirements? For plant, next please. For plant origin, and non-animal animal origin food import is carried out according to the provision of law 5996 and also the another law on biosafety, which number is 5977. And another regulations, official controls for food and feed, official controls for import of plant origin food and feed, and communiques on products subjected to control of ministry, and implementing instruction for import official control of plant origin food and feed and food contact materials also. Regulations and communiques of Turkish Food Codex, which is horizontal and vertical. And mainly these Turkish Food Codex regulations are food labeling and information consumers, nutrition and health claims, flavorings, food additives, contaminants, microbial criteria, maximum residue limits of pesticides, and materials and articles in contact with food. Yes, next. Turkish Food Codex communiques on methods of sampling, sample preparation, analysis of food, official control of levels of mycotoxins in foods. Another is method sampling official controls like this. In addition, according to the law on biosafety, genetically modified organisms, GMOs, is not approved in for food intended in Turkey. For this subject, importing food should not be produced from GMO, should not consist of GMO, and should not contain GMO, is completely banned. Yes, next. Before the import, importer or its representative should make a pre-notification from Food Safety Information System. And pre-notification is carried out in two states, as product notification and shipment notification. Yes, next. Product notification should include information of name of product, category of product, origin country, importer and importer, exporter or producer, names and addresses, and documents which are in ingredient list of the product and its label. Importer is responsible for labeling according to the Turkish Food Codex. Product notifications are examined by designated provincial directorate agriculture and forestry according to the Turkish food legislation. In this framework, the products should be compliant with Turkish food legislation and labeled according to the Turkish Food Codex regulation on labeling and consumer informing, and its guidance is important. After approving the product notification, the importer can make shipment notification at least 3 working days before estimated date of coming the consignments to customs and or requesting the official control. This Turkish map shows provincial directories of agriculture and forestry designated for import controls. Yes. Shipment notification should include lot number and quality of consignment, border point, estimated data of products coming to border point, country of dispatch, and health certificate. Yes. What's health certificate? The health certificate is a document attesting that the product's consignments are fit for food and feed. It should be issued and approved by the competent authority of origin country or dispatch country, and also include name of product, manufacturer, export information, name and sign of the official who issued and approved the certificate, a lot number and total quality of the product. On the other hand, global certificates attesting the product and or manufacturer are also acceptable. Lot number and total quality is not mandatory for this certificate. The country's competent authorities list that are authorized to issue health certificate is published and regularly updated in Directorate General website, www.tarim.gov.tr. And yes, next. The import official controls are also carried out by designated provincial directorates. Import of official control is composed of three stages. The first stage is documentary check. In this stage, electronic documents in pre-notification and original documents accompanied of the consignment are compared. Second stage is identity check. In this stage, whether documents are complied with consignment is controlled. Third stage is the last stage, is physical check. This stage is composed of organoleptic inspection, packaging control, sampling, and laboratory analysis. Sampling is carried out according to the determined frequency of analysis. This frequency is determined according to inspection of results of previous year, consumer complaints, and international notifications for each food category. Yes. As a result of the official control, finding compliant products with Turkish food legislation are allowed the entry to Turkish territory. The import control are finished. What about the export requirements? For the exporting, there's the export and its controls are carried out according to the provision of the same law 5996. And the regulations also has certificate for food of plant origin and feed export and implementing regulation for products that return from the export, issue of health certificate for food and plant origin, and feed export and implementing instruction for products from export, and Turkish food codex also. According to Article 34 of Food Law, during official controls on the export of live animals and products, the provision of this law shall apply in case the receiving country does not have any other demands. Apart from those that threaten health, products which are not in compliance with the provisions of this law can be exported on the condition that necessary explanations are made to country of this destination and after assent of that country. The exporter is obligated to comply with all measures to be taken by the minister. Yes, next please. Export controls shall start with the pre-register to the food safety information system of the products to be exported by the producer or exporter or its representative of the belonging exporting company. Yes. Application concerning exporting processes, the register made to food safety information system shall be made by the producer or observatory also representative concerning provincial district directorate from which a certificate will be requested. Next. During the inspection, if required, samples are taken by the food controller. Inspection report and analysis report are evaluated according to the recipient, country demand, and or also food, Turkish food codex. Yes. This is the summary export flow chart. Maybe fast clicking. Yes, this is the all export summaries. Next, please. Yes, next, please. Yes. And now I want to give some data for trade with Indonesia and Turkey. Yes, next please. The products imported from Indonesia, you can see the most imported products about palm and palm oil, cake, and like this. That's the another. This is the exported from Turkey to Indonesia. Generally, starch is a glucose, bicarbonate, it's generally food additives like this. Yes, change. Yes, thank you. Before I end my words, I want to say we are always ready to increase our commercial and technical cooperation with Indonesia. Our ministry, with all its specialized technical units, is keen to exchange experiences, technical know-how with your country. I would like to express that I hope to overcome the pandemic period with health, to be able to meet through mutual visits at the first opportunity. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Neslihan. Our last speaker is Dr. Mehmet Diri. He is the coordinator veterinarian from the Department of Border Inspection for Animals and Animal Products. Please give Mr. Mehmet a warm welcome.
Teşekkür ediyorum. Öncelikle bütün katılımcıları saygıyla selamlıyorum. Pandemiyle birlikte sağlıklı, kaliteli ve güvenilir gıdaya, gıdanın arzının ve erişiminin öneminin çok daha iyi anlaşıldığı böyle bir dönemde organize edilen bu foruma katkıda bulunmaktan dolayı onur duyduğumu belirtmek istiyorum. Çeviri şu an yapılıyor mu? Are you translating now? Can I go on like this? Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
We can hear you.
Are you translating? Hello.
Yes, the translator. Will you be presenting in English or Turkish?
I'm presenting in Turkish now.
Yes, that's fine. We have a translator available,
so you can just speak, and the translator will translate on the. Is it simultaneously going, or I will wait?
You can go on, please.
I can go on. Okay. Thank you. Öncelikle sunumumda sizlere daire başkanlığımızın görevleri, ilgili mevzuatı, ithalat prosedürleri, veteriner altyapısı ve veteriner kontrolleri ile ilgili bilgiler vereceğim. Ayrıca sertifikasyonla ilgili de kısa bir konuya değineceğim. Öncelikle görevlerimizden bahsetmek istiyorum. Neslihan Hanım da benden önce bahsetti bazı ortak görevlerimizden. Aynı konuları tekrar etmek istemiyorum. Kısaca özetle size sıkmadan kısa bir sunum yapmak istiyorum. Daire Başkanlığımız hayvan ve hayvansal ürünlerin ülkemize ithalatı ve ülkemizden ihracatı ile ilgili gerekli veteriner kontrollerini yürütmektedir. En başta da hayvan hastalıklarının bulaştırma riski olan bitkisel ürünlerle birlikte canlı hayvan, hayvansal ürün ve hayvansal yan ürünlerin ithalatı, transiti ve ihracatı ile ilgili gerekli resmi kontrolleri düzenlemektedir. Gıdaların ve hayvansal ürünlerin kalite ve sağlık şartlarını belirlemek, insan ve hayvan sağlığı açısından gerekli güvenlik tedbirlerini almakla sorumludur. Ayrıca uluslararası salgın hayvan hastalıklarını takip etmek, ülkelerin risk analizlerini yapmak ve varsa gerekli tedbirleri almakla sorumludur dairemiz. Ayrıca ürünlerin ülkeye girişiyle ilgili diğer ülkelerin veteriner servisleriyle de işbirliği halinde gerekli koordinasyonu sağlamaktan sorumludur. Yine bahsettiğim gibi canlı hayvan, hayvansal ürünler ve yan ürünlerin ihracat işlemlerini yürütüyoruz. Ülkelerin, ihracatçı ülkelerin ve tesislerin uygunluğunu belirlemek ve gerektiğinde sağlık ürününden denetlemekten sorumluyuz. Görev alanımıza giren hususlarla ilgili olarak da ülkelerle karşılıklı anlaşmaları yapıyoruz. Ayrıca veteriner sınır kontrol noktalarının kurulmaları ilgili usul ve esasları belirlemek, çalışmalarını takip etmek ve denetlemekten sorumluyuz. Bununla birlikte yolcu beraberi gelen ürünlerin ülkeye girişleri ve çıkışları, ayrıca ticari veya hobi amaçlı ev ve süs hayvanlarının sevkleriyle ilgili, taşınmasıyla ilgili prosedürleri belirliyoruz. Bu konularla ilgili de veri tabanları oluşturmak, istatistik veriler toplamak, analiz etmek ve eğitim faaliyetlerini yürütmekten sorumluyuz. Ayrıca sizlerin de yaptığı gibi InfoSan, Dünya Sağlık Örgütü'nün hızlı alarm sistemi olan InfoSan ve Avrupa Birliği'nin hızlı alarm sistemi olan RASF gibi hızlı alarmları alıp bunların değerlendirilmesi ve takibiyle ilgili ve geri dönüşlerle ilgili sorumluluklarımız bulunmaktadır. Evet, mevzuata geçebiliriz. Destan Hanım'ın benden önce yaptığı sunumda da değindiği gibi 5996 sayılı veteriner hizmetleri, bitki sağlığı, gıda ve yem kanunumuz dayanak teşkil etmektedir. Bildiğiniz üzere Avrupa Birliği'ne aday ülke durumundayız. Ve bu aday ülke olmamız nedeniyle, hasebiyle de ulusal mevzuatımız 2010-11 yıllarında Avrupa Birliği'ne uyumlaştırılmış Avrupa Birliği mevzuat çerçevesinde yürürlüğe girmiştir. Kısaca size yönetmeliklerimizden bahsetmek istiyorum. Diğer slide'da. Yine bahsettiğim gibi Avrupa Birliği'ne uyumlu ulusal mevzuatımız ikinci mevzuat olarak hayvan ve ürünlerin ülkeye girişinde ön bildirimlerin yapılması ve veteriner kontrolüne dair yönetmeliğimiz ve hayvan ve ürünlerin hangi hayvan ve ürünlerin veteriner kontrolüne tabi olduğunu belirleyen yönetmeliğimiz, canlı hayvanların ülkeye girişinde yürütülecek kontrollere ilişkin yönetmeliğimiz, ürünlerin ülkeye girişinde yapılacak olan kontrollere ilişkin yönetmeliğimiz, hayvan sağlığı kurallarına ilişkin yönetmeliğimiz, sertifikasyonlara ilişkin, yani canlı hayvan ve ürünlerin ülkeye girişinde yapılacak kontrollerde bakılacak veteriner sağlık sertifikalarının standart modellerine ilişkin yönetmeliğimiz ve ayrıca veteriner sınır kontrol noktalarının kurulumuyla ilgili görev ve çalışmalarına ilişkin yönetmeliğimiz. Bir sonraki slayta geçebiliriz. Görevlerde de bahsettiğim gibi hayvansal ürünlerin kişisel sevkiyatlarına ilişkin tebliğlerimiz, sığır eti ithalatında sağlık ve teknik şartlarına ilişkin tebliğimiz ve ürünlerin limanlarda, havalimanlarında olsun, deniz limanlarında olsun, aktarılması, serbest bölgeye girişleri, gümrüklü antrapolara sevkleri ya da gemi kumanyacılığı için onaylı antrapolara sevklerine ilişkin ikinci mevzuatımız bulunmaktadır. Bunlar tabii bahsettiklerim doğrudan daire başkanlığımızı ilgilendiren ikinci mevzuattı. Bir de ilgili mevzuatımız var. Neslihan Hanım da bu konulara değindi kısaca. Ben de değinmek istiyorum. Özellikle hayvan sağlığı, yem dairesi, gıda kontrol ve kodeks dairelerimizin sorumluluğunda olan ikinci mevzuatımız kapsamında kontrollerimizi yürütmekteyiz. Bunlardan özellikle yatay ve dikey mevzuata Neslihan Hanım değindi. O konulara tekrar girmek istemiyorum. Bu mevzuat kapsamında da sınır kontrol noktalarında gerekli veteriner kontrollerimizi yürütmekteyiz. Daha sonraki slayta geçebiliriz. İthalat koşulları belirli aşamalardan oluşmaktadır. Bu aşamalardan kısaca bahsetmek istiyorum. Öncelikle sağlık şartlarının belirlenmesi, yani bu hem veteriner hem de halk sağlığı şartları anlamında sağlık şartlarının belirlenmesi, onaylı ülke ve işletmelerin listelerinin oluşturulması, ikinci kademe. Bir diğer kademe ise, aşama ise, kısıtlı ülke, bölge ve hastalık listelerinin oluşturulması ve bunların yayınlanması. Ve son aşama ise bu hayvan ve canlı hayvan ve hayvansal ürünlerin, gıdaların, yan ürünlerin ülkeye giriş esnasındaki veteriner kontrolleri olmak üzere dört ana başlıkta toparlayabiliriz. Bir sonraki slide'a geçebiliriz. Burada da gördüğünüz üzere ithalat prosedürlerimiz şema olarak yer almaktadır. Öncelikle veteriner kontrolüne tabi hayvan ve ürünlerin belirlenmesi. Yani söz konusu ürün veteriner kontrolüne tabi midir, değil midir? Eğer veteriner kontrolüne tabi ise bu ürünün bahsettiğim kanunumuz çerçevesinde herhangi bir hastalık kısıtı, hayvan hastalığı kısıtı uygulanıp uygulanmadığı ürüne ilişkin ve daha sonra bu ürünün onaylı ülke, işletme veya bölgeden gelip gelmediği ve bir sonraki aşama ise veteriner sağlık sertifikasının bulunup bulunmadığı ve bu veteriner sağlık sertifikasının uygun şekilde doldurulup doldurulmadığı sorgulanır. Ve daha sonra da veteriner kontrolleri, ilgili veteriner kontrolleri bir sonraki slaytlarda bahsedeceğim. Yapılır. Ve varsa canlı hayvan gibi gerekli karantina uygulamaları yürütülür. Bir sonraki slayta geçebiliriz. Neslihan Hanım da bahsetmişti. Veteriner sağlık sertifikası zorunluluğu bizim kanunumuz gereğidir. Veteriner sağlık sertifikalarının belirlenmesi ise gerek biraz önce bahsettiğim ulusal mevzuatımız, birinci, ikinci mevzuat ve ilgili mevzuat çerçevesinde, ulusal mevzuatımız çerçevesinde veteriner sağlık sertifikası belirlenir. Yani burada veterinerlik ve halk sağlığı şartları belirlenir. Tabii bu belirleme esnasında Avrupa Birliği mevzuatı ve Dünya Hayvan Sağlığı Teşkilatı'nın tavsiyeleri de göz önünde bulundurulur. Bizim temel amacımız tüm dünya ülkeleri için tek model veteriner sağlık sertifikası. Geçmeyelim, bir önceki slayta geri dönelim. Bir önceki slayta dönebilir miyiz? Veteriner sağlık sertifikası tek model üzerinde veteriner sağlık sertifikası çalışmaları yürütülmektedir. Dönemiyoruz galiba. Ben burada bir tane slayt onaylı işletme ve ülkelere örnek vermek amacıyla et ithalatına ilişkin 10 tane ülke ve bunların kesimhanesi, işleme tesislerine ilişkin bir tablo koydum. Devam edelim. Bir sonraki slayta geçebilir miyiz? Next slide please. Biraz da kısaca size sınır kontrol noktalarımızdan bahsetmek istiyorum. Hayvan ve hayvansal ürünlerin kontrolleri ülkemize sınırlarda ülkeye girişten önce yapılmaktadır. 23 veteriner sınır kontrol noktası müdürlüğümüz, 10 tane de yetkili il müdürlüğümüz bulunmaktadır sınırlarda. Haritada bunların yerlerini görüyorsunuz. Buralarda yaklaşık olarak 250 resmi veteriner hekim ve toplam yardımcı hizmetlerle birlikte 450 personelimiz, resmi personelimiz görev yapmaktadır. Next slide please. Biraz da ithalatçının sorumluluklarından bahsetmek istiyorum. İthalattan sorumlu firma, yetkili, canlı hayvansa ithal etmek istediği ürün, en azından bir gün öncesinden, 24 saat öncesinden mutlaka bize bildirim yapmak zorundadır. Eğer ürünse sevkiyatın ülkeye girişinden önce, yani 24 saat gibi bir sınır yok ama ülkeye girişinden önce ön bildirim yapmak zorundadır. Bu ön bildirimde veteriner giriş belgesi adı verdiğimiz VGB ile yapılmaktadır. Şu anda bununla ilgili kayıt sistemimiz devreye alındı. 2019 yılından beri de aktif olarak çalışıyor. Hem ülkemize ithalat hem de transit işlemlerinde internet sayfası üzerinden, web sayfamız üzerinden bir linkle yetki alan ithalatçılar ya da transitten sorumlu transit sorumlusu şifreyle sistemimize giriş yapıp bu bildirimleri elektronik ortamda yapabilmektedir. Next slide please. Veteriner kontrollerin aşamalarından bahsetmek istiyorum. Birinci aşama belge kontrolü, ikinci aşama kimlik kontrolü, üçüncü aşama da fiziksel kontroldür. Belge kontrolünde veteriner sağlık sertifikası ve ilgili diğer dokümanlar kontrol edilir. Kimlik kontrolünde ise söz konusu sevkiyatın sertifikadaki veya ilgili diğer dokümanlardaki bilgilerle eşleşip eşleşmediği kimlik bilgileri kontrol edilir. Fiziksel kontrollerde ise bütün diğer duyusal muayene de dahil olmak üzere işte paketleme, ısı, numune alınması ve laboratuvara gönderilmesi ve sonuçları dahil olmak üzere bütün bu aşamaları içine alan bir kontrol aşamasıdır. Biz de Avrupa Birliği'nde de olduğu gibi herhangi bir yani doküman kontrolünden ya da kimlik kontrolünden geçemeyen herhangi bir ürün bir sonraki kontrol aşamasına geçemez ve ürün reddedilir. Bir sonraki slaytlarda bahsedeceğim reddettikten sonra ne olduğunu. Canlı hayvanlar için ise ayrıca bir karantina prosedürümüz var. Next slide please. Eğer ürün ulusal mevzuatımıza uygunsa iç pazarda tüketilmesine izin verilir veya varış işletmesine eğer işlenecekse, işlemden geçecekse varış işletmesine sevkine müsaade edilir. Eğer ürün ulusal mevzuata uygun değilse kanunumuz ve ilgili yönetmeliklerimiz gereği ya orijin işletmesine geri gönderilir ya özel işleme tabi tutulur veya kullanım amacı dışında farklı bir amaç için kullanılabilir. Yani burada gıda amaçlı gelmişse ürün, eğer herhangi bir işlemden geçirilerek hayvansal yan ürün olarak değerlendirilebilecekse, buna da zaten kendi içimizde ilgili dairelerimiz var. O daireler karar verir. Başka bir amaç için kullanılabilecekse hayvansal yem amacıyla olabilir. Hayvan tüketiminde kullanılacak. Veya yan ürün olabilir. Farklı bir amaç için kullanılmasına izin verilebilir. Veya imha. Burada ithalatçının ve bakanlığımızın değerlendirmeleri sonucunda karar vermektedir. Next slide please. Kısaca Endonezya'dan ithal ettiğimiz ürünlerden de bahsetmek istiyorum. Özellikle balıkçılık ürünleri ve süt içeren içecekler ithal edilmektedir. Onları bu tabloya koydum. 2019, 20 ve 21 yıllarındaki ithal ettiğimiz ürünler, yani en çok ithal ettiğimiz ürünler bunlar Endonezya'dan. Next slide please. Ben sabırla dinlediğiniz için hepinize teşekkür ediyorum. Son olarak da pandeminin sona erdiği temiz su ve sağlıklı gıdaya bütün insanların ulaşabildiği ve savaşlardan dolayı çocukların ölmediği bir dünya temenni ediyorum. Teşekkür ederim.
Thank you, Dr. Mehmet. Ladies and gentlemen, now that we have come to an end of all the presentations, I would like to open the floor for some question and answer, which will focus on our Turkish presenters. Aside from Dr. Neslihan and Dr. Mehmet, we also have Dr. Osman Çakır, who is the head of the Department of Border Control of Animal and Animal Products, and Dr. Sibel Bas, a veterinarian for the same department. I believe we have three gentlemen here who have questions for us. If you could come up to the front, please state your names, your company, to whom your question is for, and your question, please.
Good morning, Dr. Neslihan and also Dr. Mehmet. First of all, my name is Jason and I'm from PT Heinz IBC Indonesia, a part of Kraft Heinz Global Company. And at this time, I would like to ask about the retail product that needs to follow Regulation 5996, and it's related regulation including the Turkish food codex. Is there any exception for B2B or business to business product that will be further processed? Do we need to follow the packaging regulation, labeling regulation, and other related regulations, same as retail product?
I think that's it from me.
Thank you.
Dr. Neslihan,
you may answer the question. Dr. Neslihan, or Dr. Mehmet,
you may answer the question.
Yes, our regulations is the same. We also give in the our presentation. All regulations is also published in website www.tarim.gov.tr. If any specific questions, maybe write also us and send emails from mails. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Dr. Mehmet, would you like to add something to that?
Actually, our head of department, Neslihan Alper, summarized and answered the question. It's same with for us, for the animal products. All the regulations consist of the retail products as well.
Okay.
Is it clear?
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Jason.
Thank you, Mr. Jason.
Our next question, please.
Yes, you may ask.
Good morning. First of all, my name is Yusuf from Indofood, one of the well-known food producer in Indonesia. I would like to extend my question to Ms. Neslihan. I would like to understand better about the export food process to Turkey. Is there any mandatory for the physical checking for every shipment delivered to Turkey territory, especially the lab test, laboratory test? Is there any mandatory for every shipment we have to follow the physical check or lab test to Turkey territory?
Dr. Neslihan?
I also give my presentation. We don't test all export products. We have some some frequency for the products according to the country products and the risk of the products. So we make the analysis according to the frequency. We don't make all products to send the analysis, but we check all documentary check and identity check we make. But its quarantine is different. Because there is some quarantine pests, so for quarantine we make all products to control and making physical check. If there are any risk, we send to the quarantine laboratory for the pests. But for packaging foods and packaging materials, there is frequency of analysis.
Thank you.
Is it enough?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
There's one more question. Our last one.
Good morning. My name is Indrayana. I'm the Secretary General of Food Industry Association in Indonesia, known as KAPMI. I would like to address my question to Dr. Neslihan. The question is around the mandatory health certificate. I saw your presentation in page 20. It mentioned that it should include the name of product, manufacturer, or exporter information, and the name and sign of the official who issued and approved the certificate. So my question is,
We know that our authority already used the electronic signature. Wondering to know if Dr. Neslihan, Turkey also accept the electronic signature.
Thank you very much.
If your authority write to us for the electronic certificate from the official way, yes, we accept the electronic certificate, but it must be checked. There must be square code or like this. It may be it may give an information from a link or square code. If there is this. This part, yes, we accept this.
Okay,
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Very clear.
Thank
very
you.
Clear.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. Now, okay, we would like to move on to our online participants. If you want to ask question, please press the raise hand. I will call out a name, and then you can unmute your mic and then ask the question. We have the first one, Hendrawati. And you can also ask the question in Indonesian. The speakers can answer in Turkish because we have an interpreter. We'll start with Hendrawati. Can you unmute your mic, please? Okay, we'll move on to the next one first. The next one is Fidi Damayanti from Chicken Wings and Sauce. Can you unmute your mic, please?
Okay. I want to address my question to Ms. Neslihan. Okay. I saw in your presentation that there is a sauce need in Turkey, because my product is actually the versatile all-purpose barbecue sauce that you can use for anything, you know, processing the food. And I also joined in Dubai Expo right now. I'd like to know if it's there any chance from the Turkey government to do such like a business matching with the SMEs industry, the small micro entrepreneurship industry like me, to do you know, the business matching in the near future. I'd like to know, because I saw in on your presentation before that there's a need for sauce or condiments like my products. That's it for Ms. Neslihan. Ebala, thank you.
Sorry, I didn't hear the interpreter to Turkish.
Miss Fidi.
Şu an duyuyorum, teşekkür ederim. Kaçırdım ama hanımefendi.
Oh. Yeah, can you hear me now?
Evet.
Okay. I think you can repeat your question, Miss Fidi.
Yeah. Okay. I want to address my question to Ms. Neslihan, because according to her presentation, there's...
Yani biz tabii firmaları bilmiyoruz. Genelde sınırda biz ithalat gıda güvenilirliği yönüyle gıda güvenilirlik kontrollerini yapıyoruz. Hani firmalarla kendileri irtibata geçebilirler ya da hani özel bir şeyler olursa Ticaret Bakanlığı'ndan belki bilgileri alabiliriz. Ama şu an hani bizde o tür bir bilgi yok. Genelde kendilerinin bu tür firmaları bulup irtibata geçmeleri gerekiyor.
Is the answer clear? Miss Fidi?
Oh, jadi tidak ada ini ya, tidak ada misalnya kayak kerjasama dengan Turkey government untuk apa do such things gitu, seperti apa namanya, atau info apa di mana saya bisa temukan, istilahnya biasanya kan kayak di Indonesia atau di kayak mungkin setiap negara pasti punya ya, dimana kita bisa cari potential buyer yang trusted ya, bukan scamming atau scammer atau something like that gitu loh. Dimana saya bisa temukan potential buyer karena saya sangat tertarik melihat adanya kesempatan buat produk saya untuk diterima di ada permintaan sepertinya di situ gitu kan, seperti itu.
Can I answer? Yes. Sorry. Thank you, Bu Fidi.
I will speak in Bahasa Indonesia.
Sorry, Mrs. Neslihan. Because this is my college from.
Begitu Bu.
Ya.
Yani dediğim gibi herhalde konuşuyorlar mı, devam ediyor mu? Yani bizde genelde bunlar tabii alıcıyla satıcı arasındaki ilişkiler olduğu için biz de direkt hani yönlendirebileceğimiz bir firma vesaire şey olmuyor. Ama şunu belki önerebiliriz. Bu sene başlarında sanıyorum mesela bir Endonezya günü yapılmıştı kahveyle ilgili. Orada hem alıcı hem satıcılar bir araya gelmişti, İhracatçılar Birliği aracılığıyla diğer sektörler de vardı bildiğim kadarıyla ve çok fazla işbirliği yapıldı. Birçok anlaşmalar da imzalandı. Belki o tür günler düzenlenebilir. Onu hem sizin elçiliğiniz hem de bizim bakanlıklar aracılığıyla duyururlarsa oraya mutlaka ihracatçılarımız katılacaktır. İşbirlikleri çoğalacaktır diye düşünüyorum.
Ibu tadi disampaikan oleh Ibu Neslihan bahwasannya memang di Turki sendiri itu tidak ada platform seperti itu, jadi terkait potensial buyer itu mungkin bisa ditemukan melalui partisipasi pada kegiatan-kegiatan pameran ataupun expo dan sebagainya. Namun kami dari sisi pemerintah hanya bisa mendukung apabila ada kegiatan perkenalan Indonesia seperti itu dan ada hadir perwakilan dari Kadin ataupun perusahaan-perusahaan yang ada di Turki untuk kemudian melalui pertemuan itu bisa bertemu dengan Indonesia seperti itu.
Baik, terima kasih.
Terima kasih.
Thank you so much.
We'll move on to the next question.
From Arum M. PT Anugrah Indofood Barokah Makmur. Can you please unmute your mic? If you want to ask in Indonesian, that will also be all right.
Suruh Gilzer.
Arum M. from PT Anugrah Indofood Barokah Makmur.
Saya sini aja boleh sini, mikrofon nuju aja boleh sini, bis dua bilirin.
Apa masih di mute atau gimana? Atau Ernawati.
I think we've disconnected. We'll move on to the next one from Ernawati of Rasa Rosa. Can you please unmute your mic?
Oke, terima kasih. Mohon maaf, saya menggunakan bahasa Indonesia. Saya ingin menanyakan, untuk saya ini adalah Bipotok. Yang saya ingin tanyakan, Bipotok ini terbuat dari rempah-rempah pilihan dan sudah mempunyai BIRT dan halal. Adakah potensi untuk produk saya ini untuk dipasarkan di negara mana gitu? Itu aja sih pertanyaannya. Terima kasih.
Untuk Ibu Ratna mungkin.
Silakan. Ibu Ernawati, terima kasih atas pertanyaannya. Sebetulnya tergantung pada kebiasaan dari negara masing-masing ya Bu ya. Semua sebetulnya produk-produk pangan jika memang mempunyai kualitas yang bagus dan juga sudah memiliki izin ya, itu ada potensi Bu untuk bisa di ekspor ya. Tergantung dari negara tujuan ekspor apakah memang ada yang berminat begitu. Saya kira itu Bu. Makasih.
Ya, makasih.
Are there any more questions from the chat room? If you have more questions, please raise your hand. I don't think there are any more. Since there are no more questions, that concludes our forum today. But before you go, I would like to kindly ask the participants to fill out a form, an evaluation form for today's business forum. We will also send the link later via the chat room. We would like to thank our participants as well as our speakers today for sharing their knowledge and expertise. Your insight is very, very useful for us and for the future of import and export to Indonesia, hopefully with Turkey. So ladies and gentlemen, it has been an honor and delight to share this morning event with you. We hope that you enjoyed the forum as much as we enjoyed having you with us. Hopefully we'll see you again soon. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and have a good evening, afternoon.
Ana sayfasına girdiniz mi?